Well, hello, it's a new day. I'm going to go back to filling this up. As much fun as the vintage and plate is, this one's faster. Another thing, I picked up the loose balloons and kind of mix them up, whatever, and put them in a little coffee tin. And this is a fun thing to do. You get little coffee tins, just throw them away, peel the label off, and paint them a color that you like.
Thank you.
thing I'm noticing is that I have a lot more defective Vortex balloons than other brands, but I'm also noticing that the Vortex are a lot easier to tie than the others. Some of them are really hard to tie. Thank you. back to work.
Thank you.
Balloons. I want to use up the Quilatex balloons. Reason why is they may be the cheapest, but I'm having a lot of defective balloons from Quilatex. And so I want to get rid of, I just want to use these up. I was trying to get a nice mix of the colors, but anyway, I want to use these up. And some of these, I didn't even get a whole, I didn't even get a whole balloon. You know, it's just like it was cut off even before. Like the whole nose, neck and nozzle were missing. And holes and self-destructs and whatnot. I guess it's like they say, you get what you pay for. I will say the Quilatex are the easiest to tie. That's a good thing. The Decamax are the hardest to tie. Some of the chrome purple ones and the rose gold ones are Decamax, and they are really difficult to tie. They're really kind of taking a toll on my fingers. And the Gamal and the Cadex are somewhere in between. At least at this point, my recommendation for if you're buying chrome balloons is Gamal and Cadex. And probably not so much for Quilatex and not so much for Decamax. But anyway, I'm going to take a little break. I'm going to pick this up again tomorrow to finish off these balloons. So, alright. Until then, it'd be a shame to be yourself. And have fun out there.